Hello, TAF at Saghalie community. My name is Christina Spencer, and as the proud principal of TAF at Saghalie, I welcome you to the virtual graduation ceremony for the class of 2020. Our ceremony will begin with pomp and circumstance, followed by the national anthem. Thank you. I'd like to recognize Federway Public Schools Superintendent Dr. Tammy Campbell, our school board members, Board President Jeffrey McAnalloy, Vice President Trudy Davis, Director Hiroshi Eto, Director Dr. Jennifer Jones, Director Lakeisha Phillips, our district officials, Deputy Superintendent Dr. Danielle Pfeiffer, Learning Improvement Officer Martin Boonstra, Learning Improvement Officer, Diane Ellis, Learning Improvement Officer, Marla Newton, Learning Improvement Officer, Christopher Carter, and our school officials, Assistant Principal of TAF at Saghalie, Ida Acton. And now I'd like to welcome our student speakers. Our first student speaker is going to be Ms. Shanari Brent, and our second student speaker is going to be Ms. Nayeli Soltero.
Good evening, families, friends, teachers, and my fellow graduates. I don't really know where to begin, but I'll start off with, we made it. We actually made it. We were able to pull through after all the good times and even the bad times. The class of 2020 was able to pull through by relying on each other and on our teachers when we needed them most. When TAF first moved to Saghalie at the beginning of our sophomore year, We were all scared and nervous teenagers, and we didn't know anything about the new school community. I personally feel that we had to create a new school community and culture. Sophomore year was a rough year for many of us, but for our new school as a community, we were still in the transition process. When we all wanted to give up on the idea of staying at TAF at Saghalie, we still had hope that TAF was the right school to attend and to graduate from. I would like to take a minute to thank all the teachers that we've had from the past to the present. Through all those teachers, we have learned many new things about ourselves, our goals, and our dreams. Three things that I have learned through the past years are: one, you should never tell yourself that you cannot achieve a certain goal or you cannot do something, because the more that you tell yourself you cannot do something, you'll start to believe it. Two, never let anyone dictate or tell you what you should or should not do. You should always listen to your instincts. And three, never fall into peer pressure, because you should never have to change your core principles and beliefs for someone else. I personally feel that the best part about attending TAF are the memories that we've made as a class. My top three memories are: one, when I was able to attend Imagine Tomorrow, I was able to tour the Washington State University campus, and I was able to give out my research. My second best memory was when I was a freshman and I was in one of my favorite classes, biology, and we were playing bus shuffle outside and we were all having a good time and vibing with our teacher. My third and final best memory is when I was also a freshman in Miss McLean's class. Miss McLean gave each of us a marble that we would have with us during high school and return it at graduation. Guys, that means we made it. To me, TAF isn't just about completing schoolwork, but it's about making amazing connections with the people around you. Who would have thought that during our senior year, whenever we were so eager to leave high school and we're so eager to have a graduation, a virus would hit? But that's okay. We were all still together in a way that will keep us safe and healthy. Even though we are not able to have a traditional graduation, I feel like our school in particular has truly never had a traditional feeling, culture, or high school experience. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. At TAF, we have been able to learn how to adapt to new conditions and new situations. At TAF, we were given the chance to learn about new cultures and understand the people around us and around the world. Those are only some of the unique opportunities that we've been able to take away from being at TAF and Saghalie. By attending a STEM school and having all these amazing opportunities, it has helped us grow as people. We are now able to go into the world where we will be the next generation of CEOs, doctors, engineers, and teachers. And we will use the skills that we have learned at TAF to become amazing people in the world. Our high school graduation is not the end of our journey, but it's the beginning of our life journey. Wherever your individual journey takes you, allow yourself to grow and to enjoy the journey of your life. The life that you want to live is all up to you from now on. If you are here with me as a fellow graduate, you have the capability to make something out of yourself. Our lives start now. This graduation is a launching point to our futures. And we are all going to land exactly where we need to be and where we are being called to be. Before we can reach for our dreams, we have to complete another important milestone, and that is to graduate. Thank you.
I never thought that 4 years of my life could pass by so quickly. Now that I'm officially a high school graduate, I reflect on a place and people that gave me a lifetime of memories that I will cherish forever. I look at TAF and Saghalie as a place who gave me an opportunity to learn who I want to be in the world and how I want to change it. TAF has also given me memories that I will cherish for a lifetime, but most importantly, TAF and Saghalie has given me a family. I'm going to present a speech about friendship. Friendship is one of the treasures that anyone can possess. God gave us the right to choose friends because they will be with us forever. I say forever because regardless if these people will be in our lives forever, the impact they have made on us will. True friends always support each other, even during the hardest of times. A true friend is one who feels happy for our successes, and on the other hand, who feels sorry for our failures. A true friend may criticize us so that we may come out of our shortcomings. They encourage us if we make a mistake and guide us to the right path. That is why it is being said that true friends is the most precious treasure in our life. In my life, I have met amazing people who have forever changed me. The people I have shared the classroom with for the last 7 or 4 years have encouraged each other, helped each other, and cheered each other on. I believe that we have become friends who will be with each other forever. I would like to end it by saying thank you to my teachers, my administrators, and my friends for giving me everything that I could have dreamed high school could offer. Going to TAF is one of the best decisions I've ever made, and I will forever remember the experiences I made here and I had. If it wasn't for my second home, I would have never been able to accomplish my goals. Thank you.
Thank you, scholars, for those inspiring words to the class of 2020. Now I'd like to welcome Technology Access Foundation Executive Director Trish Malines-DeZico.
Good evening. This is our 9th graduating class, and what a year full of surprises you have had. One day I was walking the halls asking about college acceptances. Next thing you know, you're learning at home because school's out for the year. Now, what doesn't surprise me is how you've handled yourselves during this very strange time in our lives. Although your graduation isn't what we pictured it or what you thought it would be, I'll have to say that watching you pick up your diploma while you were wearing your caps and gowns, as your families took pictures from their cars, gave us all the feels. You are truly a special group of graduates. Thaddeus, Jack, Colby, Christopher, Nicholas, Arshdeep, Rebecca, Simon, Jaden, Megan, Sondari, Alexander, Steve, Lydia, Karina, Nageli, the two Aarons, Gregory, Kevin, and Samuel. You all started as tiny little sixth graders full of energy and wonder. And in your 7 years here, you became the heart and soul of your cohort. You've experienced how long, and at the same time, how short, 7 years can be. It really doesn't matter when you join TAF Academy or TAF at Saghalie. What matters is each one of you have made wonderful contributions to our learning community, and we are all the better for it. Now, you are about to take your next big step in life. What gives me the most pride and hope for our communities and our nation is how you've developed as leaders. You are actually exactly what our communities and country need right now. I know that no matter what stage in life you're in, no matter where you are, you will find a way to lead and bring along others with you. Now it's time for us to send you off to your next journey. So I'm going to leave you with this little nugget I've left each graduating class before you. Take chances. Be bold. Be silly. It's okay. Living a box has never been where the magic happens. Stretch your creativity further than ever before to make the world better than it has ever been. Remember, no matter where we are and no matter where you are, we are all still together. The village is strong and growing, and you are forever a part of it. Go out there and change the world, TAF at Saghalie class of 2020. Congratulations to you and your families. Thank you.
Thank you, Trish, for those encouraging and supportive words. Now I'd like to introduce our superintendent, Dr. Tammy Campbell.
Right. graduating class of 2020. Well, you hung in there and you did it. I'd like to start out by thanking our staff for all of your hard work and making sure the class of 2020 celebrations conveyed the care and commitment we have to our seniors. Parents, I know these have been unprecedented times, and you found yourself at home teaching and doing education work in a way that you never would have imagined. I, again, want to applaud you because we simply could not have done this without you. Thank you. There is an expression that I think is appropriate for the times we find ourselves in. And it simply states, it is always darkest before the dawn. Class of 2020, look up and look out. Dawn is coming. And with it will be so many opportunities to make our communities, our workspaces, our learning places, our states, our nation, our world much better. And I believe it will be our youth who will be key to that, because they will be the trailblazers for how we treat our planet and each other if we are to thrive in our global community. Scholars like Jack Andraka, who at age 14 won the grand prize at the 2012 International Science Fair for finding a method to detect early stages of pancreatic cancer. Or Malala Yousafzai, who at age 17 fought fiercely for women and girl rights to an education. Or Jaquiel Jackson, who at the age of 8 helped people suffering from homelessness and those in need by offering blessing bags filled with supplies and food to over 35,000 people. Or our very own Daniel Chung, who made over 100 cloth masks for the Federal Way community to ensure those who needed it could be safe from the pandemic. Seniors, I know this has been a difficult last few weeks and months. Having to leave your school setting so abruptly without closure on the things that are uniquely important to you. Your friends, your clubs, sports, your classrooms, your social networks, your once-in-a-lifetime memories as a senior. The basic human connections that you hold most dear. But this is where we are. It's not going to last, though. It will end. How can you take the letdown and the disappointment of unfinished business and turn it into good? What will you do to make an impact? What will be your legacy? We need you. We need your compassion. We need your creativity. We need your perspective on differences, your courage, and your intellect to blaze new trails. Class of 2020, take the pain of this year and turn it into fuel to leave a lasting and positive impact on our world. Go to it, class of 2020. Go and change the world.
Thank you, Dr. Campbell, for your encouraging and motivating words. We appreciate your vision and leadership to our district. Now, TAF at Saghalie, class of 2020, scholars, family, and friends, I'm excited to take a moment to celebrate all of the things that our TAF at Saghalie scholars have accomplished and to look to the unique possibilities that are awaiting for them in the future. And though this is not how we initially intended to share this graduation experience, and though there may be things that worry us during the critical time in our world's history, know that there are also unparalleled opportunities unfolding for you, scholars, as you own your roles as leaders, designers, innovators, and justice seekers. We are entering a moment in history when we will reflect back on those who stood up, posed bold and game-changing ideas, and led fearlessly. Your time at TAF at Saghalie has prepared you for this very moment, for the opportunity to stand when others do not know how to. I want to share some wise words that I believe were written for you for this day. Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. You may ask yourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, fabulous? I say, who are you not to be? You are a TAF at Saghalie graduate. Your playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel secure around you. TAF at Saghalie graduates are all meant to shine. And as you let your light shine, you will unconsciously give others permission to do the same. As you are liberated from fear, your presence automatically liberates others. This quote, taken from famous author, politician, and activist Marianne Williamson, was written for you. To me, it speaks to the talents that manifest in you because of your diverse experiences at TAF at Saghalie. You are trailblazers, visionaries, and freedom fighters who must step up and step out to shine on the world stage. When you show up, you are unstoppable. Because of your grit, you define the image and the spirit of the wolf at TAF at Saghalie. Your spirit, drive, leadership, and energy will forever live in the hearts and minds of all that were in our community. I'm not sure if you know this, but TAF at Saghalie class of 2020, you showed out in many ways. Half of your class earned a GPA of 3.5 or higher, and over 60% of your class earned a GPA of 3.0 or higher. Almost 90% of you are attending a 2 or 4 year post-secondary learning opportunity. And a few of you are making the ultimate sacrifice by serving our country and community in the military and the world of work. Last but not least, as a class, you earned a whopping $1.7 million in scholarships and awards towards your post-secondary education. You have defined the image and the soul of a wolf at TAF at Saghalie. Your service, intellect, spirit, and leadership and energy will forever be in our hearts and minds. And in front of every strong wolf, we know is an even stronger pack. We know that none of this would be possible without your cheerleaders, protectors, biggest supporters, your families. Thank you, families. You have watched your precious gifts grow in every step of the way in this journey. From babies to children to teenagers and now high school graduates and then young adults. I know that you have joy in your hearts today as you look upon these fine young people with such great pride. Remember, families, that this day is also a tribute to you. Thank you for all of your support and for loving the amazing group of young people unconditionally. Thank you also for sharing them with us at TAF at Saghalie. They have made a difference in our school and in our lives. TAF at Saghalie teachers, staff, and foundation members, we haven't forgotten you. You are definitely a factor in this success equation. You always came prepared to inspire, model, and teach. Thank you for choosing to do this work with and for our scholars. Wolfpack scholars, I have 3 small requests of you in the coming years. Number 1, remember, you are the designers, the master crafters, and the artists of your next life's journey. Your possibilities are unlimited. The world needs your heart, talents, and leadership now more than ever. As you move into the world, know that you, just as you are enough. Number 2, take risks. Live on the edge. You cannot take over the world by playing it safe. And number 3, Terry Crews once said, strength comes from standing up. Standing is a single movement that affirms the power within. You have the power and the will to compel the mind to move the body. By standing up, you assert your personal, immutable superpower. And finally, Wolfpack scholars, know that your presence has grown me as a person and as a school leader. I will forever be proud to have served as your principal. It is an honor to salute you. Congratulations, TAF at Saghalie, class of 2020. Now go show the world who you are. As principal of TAF at Saghalie, I certify that the graduating class of 2020 has successfully completed all graduation requirements of the state of Washington and of Federal Way Public Schools. At this time, our board director, Director Hiroshi Edo, will accept the class of 2020.
Technology Access Foundation graduates, salutations. You probably haven't heard that since elementary school when your teacher was reading from Charlotte's Web. Now you're all grown up and ready to graduate. I hope this finds you and yours in good health, great spirit, and happiness on the occasion of your graduation. Your diploma is going to open up alternate universes to your future. A college degree might open others, just as polishing your skills in the arts, or mastering a craft, or joining the military. Every experience in your interpretation of life is going to open up alternate universes to your future as well. So I wish you the very best on your journey of self-discovery. The fact that I am recording this is an indication of uncertain times, but there is certainty in knowing that each of us matters. What you say and do will affect the world around us. So cherish your life, do good, and have a great impact on the world. I wish you the very best on your journey of self-fulfillment of all your promise to the world. Now, on behalf of the Board of Directors for Federal Way Public Schools District Number 210 and our community, it is my honor and privilege to accept the Technology Access Foundation graduating class of 2020. Go Wolves!
Now, Miss Elizabeth Benitez will be presenting the class of 2020 on behalf of Federal Way Public Schools.
Phyllis Achampong. Shaneri Brent. Saida Dungu. Thaddeus Dezeu. Jack Ellis. Aaron Falcon. Jesus Garcia. Colby Harrington. Christopher Heredia. Aaron Ho. Nicholas Ibarra Corral. Arshdeep Kaur Gill. Alexander Wayne Kilpatrick. Rebecca Lockhart. Simon Lopez Magana. Eric Madrigal Arenas. Jaden Miles. Megan Eileen Montiel Sanchez. Al Obeso. Eva O'Neill. Jaden Regal. Sunduri Daniela Rodriguez. Alexander Rosales. Steve Shannon Saviano. Lydia Solomon. Karina Soltero Valdovinos. Nayeli Soltero Valdovinos. Gregory Valenzuela. Kevin Bo. Morgan Washington. Samuel Yoon.
Congratulations to the TAF at Saghalie class of 2020. Now, ASB President and your TAF at Saghalie valedictorian, Kevin Vo, will lead us in the turning of the tassels.
Congratulations to the class of 2020 on making it this far. Now, if you may turn your tassels from right to left, the celebration may now start. Thank you so much.
We are so proud of you, class of 2020. Now, go out into the world, make moves, and make history.